Hello everybody, today I have this 2010 Freightliner Cascadia and today I'm going to show you how to replace the brake chamber. In this case, this brake chamber has air brakes disc, you can see. Today I'm going to give you the full demonstration on how to replace this brake chamber. The first thing we're gonna do is to cut these zip ties to remove this cable from this line, because we're gonna disconnect this line. Then after that, we're gonna grab a 7/8 wrench or a 22 millimeter to remove this from here. Sometimes can be tight, sometimes can be loose, it depends. To get it completely out of there. The hose is out, as you can see. So the next step is to remove the hose from here. This right here is going to be a 11/16 wrench to remove this one, like this. This is optional, you can do it outside, but over here is easier because this is on its blade and it's easier to remove it. We have it out. So I'm gonna put it on a side somewhere when it's safe. Now we are going to remove this fitting over here. We are going to be using a 7/8 again to remove this fitting. It's pretty easy. I'm gonna rotate it to the left to remove it. Like this, until it comes out. So now we just remove the fitting completely. Now the fitting is right here. This is the way it looks. You can remove the brake chamber completely with everything, but it's easier to remove it right here because the brake chamber is hole by the bolts and you can use a lot of pressure to remove this one sometimes. So that's the reason why it's better to remove them right here. Now the brake chamber is ready for removal. The only bolts that are holding the brake chamber are these two, this one and this one right there. They are 15/16 on size. So we're just gonna put the wrench right here and we're going to remove the brake chamber. In this case, it feels like this one is loose. Oh, that's the whole caliper, the one is moving. Okay, that's cool. It has to have play anyway. Alright, so just gonna put the wrench right here and we're gonna remove it. This can be tight sometimes. It is tight, so we're gonna put extension wrench and do it again. Alright, out. We'll do the same one, the same thing with the other one. Extension wrench. And pressure. Alright. It is out. Okay, so now I'm just gonna remove the bolts completely, the nuts completely, until and out. In this case, this brake chamber has no pressure at all because it's the front brake. This is a service brake only. If you have the parking brake, in the case of the rears, they're gonna have pressure. So you have to release the brake, press the yellow valve to release the pressure from the brake chamber, remove the bolts, and then remove the brake chamber, and then pull the brake, and then the pin is going to, the rod is going to get out, and then you disconnect the hose. So that's how you do if you have the other type of brake chamber, I mean, the Tori in that case. Well, I don't know what designation is for that one. In this case, this is a T20, but that's how you wanna do that. So continue on this one until I get it up. So the bolts are, the nuts are removed, the two nuts. Here I have them. They're fine thread, so it will take a while to remove them. Now it's easy to remove the brake chamber. You just hold it and remove it like this. There is no pressure going on. See, we have the rod right there. And we have the orifice that goes right there. You can see? That's all you got there. That's where the rod goes, like pushes the brake pads, and adjust the whole thing there because of the adjuster right there and whole mechanism works. So this one is ready to go to the trash because it's leaking air when you press the brakes. So we have the new brake chamber ready for installation. Here I have the new part number. This is the part number in case you wonder, and it says then it's for the this type, a type 20, a T20, and the part number. So let's compare it to the old one. All right, here we have both of them. See the same length over here. You can measure it if you want, because this one just push it doesn't have. If you have the other type, the Tori is going to be a little different because it's going to be larger, but it's going to be the same basic brake chamber. And also some very important tag that you have to compare is this one. You see it says type 20 over here, T20, and we have the T20 over here, and that means then it's the brake chamber. The part number varies because this one is an older version. This part number is different, but it's an updated part number, and we have the orifice for the air supply in the same location. Both of the brake chamber are in the same location, so that's something that you have to be sure when you are ready to install the parts, because sometimes can vary depending on the application of the system. But now this one is ready for installation. The installation on this one is pretty simple, just the same way we remove it. And remember, the airline was going to the rear of the vehicle, so all we have to do is to align it with the orifices right there, like this, see, and it's in. Simple, pretty easy. All you have to do probably is to check that there is nothing in between, like rust or anything, but there, if the surface is clean, you're clear for installation. But if you see something in between, you clean that first and then go ahead and install the whole thing. So we are ready for installation. Oh, and something very important is to see then this seal right here is not stuck in this surface over here. In this case, it's not. It is stuck in the other brake chamber right here. You can see here it has the seal, and that's all. That's pretty much all. So the kit, well, the brake chamber in this case comes with a little bit of grease. This is a pack of grease right here, and the two nuts. The pack of grease is just to apply on the rod, so we're gonna apply a little bit of grease over there, and we're gonna install the new nuts, and we're gonna tie that up. All right, we have the grease right there, and we are going to reinstall it. I just wanted to show you the grease right there, and that's it. We are going to install the two nuts. Here is the other one. Okay, now I'm going to tie them. These are like fine thread nuts, so it's gonna take a while to tie them. So many rotations, but you don't over tighten, but it's really hard to over tighten. So this one takes a lot of pressure. So just make sure to tighten enough, just the same way as you remove it, so that way this one doesn't get loose. But because this one is a secure, it has a secure nut right here, so it won't come out even if you leave it loose. But the brake chamber can just like play around and can damage something. So that's the reason why you tighten enough, just enough as it was before. So let's do that right now. We have the brake chamber in place. These bolts are completely tight. Just make sure to double check them, then they are in the right position. Well, it cannot be in the opposite position, but this one can be. So just make sure that everything is right in the right position. So once we have that, we are ready to continue. We're gonna install the fitting. In this case, I already applied Teflon tape. It's very important that you do that, otherwise it can start leaking air as soon as you install it. So this one is easy. We just like thread in, and we tighted with the same wrench, the 7/8 wrench or 22 millimeter. It's the same one. Now tighten it and leave it in the same position as it was, or similar position as it was. Something like this it was. So that's all you have to be sure, just to leave it in the same position. So we have this one on position, so now it's time to install the other hose, just the same way as we remove it. And remember, I already installed Teflon tape. It's very important that you do the same to prevent leaks after you install the brake chamber. So I'm going to install this one. This one requires a little more attention to install it, so I'm gonna need both hands already in. All right, cool, that's it. So it is already in, so now I'm gonna rotate it until it gets tight, and we're gonna be using the same wrench, the 11/16, and we're gonna leave it almost the same or the same position as it was before. It is right on the position where it's supposed to go. You can see the way the hose goes. As soon as the steering wheel gets straight, this one is gonna stretch and it's gonna go back to the position how it was. So we just wanna get this one there. Not in yet. All right, now it's in. And we are going to tighten it using the same wrench, the 7/8 wrench, the 22 millimeter, and that one is easy because you don't have to hold it. Just make sure that this one doesn't move, because this one is moving to the front, so we have to rotate this one to the back to put it in the right position. See, it moves to the front, so we have to hold it with the other hand and tighten. Oh, like this will be all right. See, it is tight. And now I'm going to install the cable. I'm gonna put the zip ties to the cable, and with that I'm going to finish the job. So let me put the zip ties right now. And finally, it is right on place. As you can see, make sure that the cable is not touching, the ABS cable is not touching anywhere near to the tire or near to the brake chamber right here, because it can be destroyed. The hose is right in position, secure with the zip ties, and everything is right on place. The nuts are tight, the hose are tight on both ends. So this job is done. So all you have to do now is just go over there, press the brake, make sure that there is no leaks, and that's it. Nothing else to do. Pretty simple. This one's actually, this try of brake chambers on the air, this system is easier, because you don't have to remove the clevis, you don't have to adjust the brake or something, stuff like that. You only remove the brake chamber, get it out, put the new one, remove the hose, and that's it. Pretty simple. Anyway, if you have any questions about this video, you can use this comment section below, where you can leave questions, comments, recommendations, or anything else to add. Something that was left on this video then I didn't mention, you can use it there. That way we can get the information that we are looking for. And if it's not, if it is the information, if not on the video, you can leave it on the comment section below, so other people can understand what they are looking for. If you have any type of donations or contributions to say to my channel, you can do it as well. You can check the description of this video, where I have details how to send support to my channel, so I can continue making helpful videos for everybody, so we all learn something new. Make sure to subscribe to the channel. If you want to see extra content, you can follow me on Instagram, Francisco Maya YouTube. That's how you can find me. And make sure to stay tuned for all the videos, and share the video for anybody that wants to see more content about trucks. Thank you for watching.